Hello everyone, this is Mohit Singh Katoch. Working as Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department of Tulsiram Ji Gaikwad Patil College of Engineering and Technology, Nagpur. I welcome you all in yet another video lecture series of the subject Surveying 2. Today we are going to solve tachyometric surveying numericals. This video will be divided into certain parts depending upon the types of methods which are used for solving these numericals. So we will now start with the numerical questions of tachyometric surveying. In tachyometric surveying, there are basically two main types of methods which are used for solving the numericals. First is fixed hair method, second one is tangential hair method. Today we are going to see few cases of fixed hair method. So fixed hair method, case one is when the line of sight is horizontal and the staff is held vertical. So in the diagram you can see we have installed our device at station P. We have kept a staff at station Q and we are seeing the staff from the eyepiece of our device, and this dotted line represents the line of sight. So in this case the line of sight is parallel to the ground level, hence we can say that the line of sight is horizontal and the staff is held exactly vertical. So this is case number one. Here S is known as staff intercept, which is the difference between the top crosshair reading and the bottom crosshair reading, and D is the distance between the instrument station and the staff station. In this case the distance between station P and station Q is denoted by D. HI means height of the instrument from the ground level. So this is HI. And in this case 1, the theta, that is the angle of sight, is 0 degree as the line of sight is horizontal. So this is all about case number 1. Now we will see case number 2. So case number 2 is when the line of sight is inclined and the staff is held vertical. So in this case, as you can see, the instrument is set up at station A. Two stations, station B and station benchmark, has been taken where staff has been kept. From station A, when we see towards station B, the angle is inclined, that is 8 degree 20 minutes positive. Hence we can say that station B is at a higher elevation as compared to station A. And in this second case, when we see this benchmark station staff from instrument station A, the angle is minus 6 degree 40 minutes. That means this station benchmark is at a lower elevation from station A. So here H is the height between the middle crosshair reading and the bottom of the staff, and V is the distance between the middle crosshair reading and the horizontal line of sight of the instrument. Similarly, at station B, we can see H2 is the distance between middle crosshair reading and staff station B ground level, and V2 is the vertical distance between the middle crosshair reading and the horizontal line of sight of our instrument. So this is H2, V2. Here it is H1, V1, and a horizontal distance between station A and station 1 of benchmark is D1, and the horizontal distance between station A and staff station B is D2. So this is case number 2, where line of sight is at an inclination. It is not at 0 degree, it is having some inclination, either positive inclination or negative inclination, but the staff is held vertical, just like the first case. Now we will see the third case. So case number 3 is when the line of sight is inclined, just like case number 2, and the staff is held normal to the line of sight. That is, it is not held vertically, but it is kept at normal with the line of sight. So you can see the line of sight is also inclined at certain degree. In this case 2 degree 45 minutes here and 3 degree 30 minutes here, and our staff which is kept at station Q and station P is also inclined at certain angle. H1 and H2 are similar, that is the distance between the middle crosshair reading and the bottom of the staff. And V1 is the distance between, vertical distance between the middle crosshair reading and the horizontal line of sight of the instrument. So here you can see V2 is vertical distance between middle crosshair reading of staff station Q and the horizontal line of sight. So let us now begin the solving of numericals based on these three cases. So case number one of fixed air method, when the line of sight is horizontal and the staff is held vertical. So for solving this case one, we will use the formula of horizontal distance D is equal to Ks plus C. This is the most basic formula of fixed air method, which is used to calculate the horizontal distance between the staff station and the instrument station. So in this formula, capital D is equal to horizontal distance between the two stations. S is the staff intercept. As I told you in the beginning, staff intercept is the difference between the top crosshair reading and the bottom crosshair reading. K is the multiplying constant and C is the additive constant. So about multiplying constant and additive constant, we have studied in depth during our theoretical lecture classes. So you must be remembering what is multiplying constant and what is additive constant. So these are DSKC. Our formula is D is equal to K multiplied by S plus C. So we'll use this formula in our case number one numericals. So numerical number one, the question is, the following readings were taken with a tachyometer onto a vertical staff. We have to calculate the tachyometric constants. That is, we have to calculate these K and C, which are our tachyometric constants. K is multiplying constant and C is additive constant. We have to calculate both these constants. So the data given here is horizontal distance of staff station A and staff station B from our instrument station is 45 meter and 60 meter respectively. At staff station A, having distance of 45 meter, the bottom crosshair reading was 0.885, middle crosshair reading was 1.110, and top crosshair reading was 1.335. Similarly, at staff station 2, which is at 60 meter distance from our instrument station, bottom crosshair reading was 1.860, middle reading was 2.160, and top reading was 2.460. So using these informations, we will now start solving. So we know our basic formula is D is equal to Ks plus C. As we have two different stations at 45 meter and 60 meter distance, we will divide this formula in two parts. D1 is equal to Ks1 plus C for station 1 and D2 is equal to Ks2 plus C for station number 2. So using the first formula, D1 is equal to Ks1 plus C, we know the distance D1 is 45 meter. Here it is given, horizontal distance is 45 meter. So D1 is 45, D2 will be 60 in next formula. So D1 is 45, K we have to find out. S1 is the staff intercept at station 1. So we will calculate this by minusing bottom reading from top reading. So in this case, top reading is 1.335 and bottom reading is 0.885. So we will write down their difference is 0.45. So 0.45 is our staff intercept S1 plus C. C is our additive constant, which is also unknown. We have to find this out. So using these values, we form equation number 3. 45 is equal to K in the bracket 0.45 plus C. Similarly, we will form equation number 4 using this equation 2. So D2 is equal to Ks2 plus C. We have written this from equation number 2. So putting the values from the table, D2 is 60 meter. Here it is given, D2 is 60 meter. K again unknown, C is unknown. S2, staff intercept at station number 2. We will calculate using this top reading and bottom reading. So we have written here the top reading 2.460 minus bottom reading 1.860. Their difference is 0.6. Using these values, we can see that the equation is 60 is equal to K 0.6 plus C. If we rearrange this equation in terms of C, the new equation will be C is equal to this 60. This value will go on that side, and 60 minus K is equal to 0.6. So we can give number 4 to this equation, which gives the value of C. So now we will put the value of equation number 4, that is this value of C, in equation number 3. So what is equation number 3? This 45 is equal to K 0.45 plus C. Here we will put the value of C from equation number 4. So it becomes 45 is equal to K 0.45 plus C, equation 3. So putting the value of C, 45 is equal to K 0.45 plus 60 minus K into 0.60. This is the value of C. Solving this equation, we get minus 15 is equal to minus 0.15 K, and by solving these two, we get the value of multiplying constant K is equal to 100. So in this fashion, we have calculated the multiplying constant, that is the tachymetric constant K. Its value is 100. Now we will put the value of K again in equation number 3. So our equation number 3 is 45 is equal to K 0.45 plus C. So we will put the value of K as 100. We have just calculated this 100. So 45 is equal to 100 multiplied by 0.45 plus C, and solving this equation, we get the value of additive constant C as 0. Here C is equal to 0 signifies that our tachyometer is having an analytic lens, and hence the value of additive constant is 0. So in this manner, we have calculated the tachymetric constants K and C using the formula D is equal to Ks plus C. So this is the solution of numerical number 1. Now we will see numerical number 2. The stadia readings with horizontal sight at a vertical staff held 50 meters away from the tachymeter were 1.385 and 2.380 respectively. The focal length of the object glass was 25 cm. The distance between the object glass and Trunnian axis of a tachyometer was 15 cm. We have to calculate the stadia interval. So using these values given in the question, we will write down the values here. So our basic formula was D is equal to Ks plus C, where K is multiplying constant. It can also be written as F divided by I, where F is our focal length, which is given as 25 centimeter, and I is the stadia interval, which we have to calculate. S is the staff intercept, and C is our additive constant. It can be written as F plus D, where D is our distance between the object glass and the Trunnian axis of the tachyometer. Here it is given as 15 centimeter. So here D is equal to 50 meter. It is given in the question itself. The stadia readings with horizontal sight at a vertical staff held at 50 meter away. So this is our capital D, 50 meter. S is our staff intercept. This is our top staff reading, and this is bottom staff reading. These are also given in the question here. This is top reading 2.380, and this is bottom reading 1.385. Their difference is 0.995 meter. So this is our S. F is our focal length of the object glass. It is given as 25 centimeter. So here we will write as 25 centimeter. As above two values are in meter, we have to write 18 meter itself, and 25 centimeter is equal to 0.25 meter. Small d, it is given as 15 centimeter in the question. Here you can see it is given as 15 centimeter, the distance between the object glass and the Trunnian axis. So 15 centimeter is 0.15 meter. So we have the value of d here in this formula. D, we are having the value of s, we are having the value of f, and we are having the value of d. So only unknown value is I, which is the stadia interval, which we have to calculate. So we will now put all these values in our equation number 1. So we'll put the value of d 50 meter, s 0.995, f 0.25, and d 0.15 in this equation number 1. So we have placed the values here. D is equal to 50, f is 0.25, s is 0.995, I is unknown, so it is written as I only, plus f is 0.25 and d is 0.15. Solving this equation in calculator, we get the value of I as 0.005 meter, which in terms of mm becomes 5 mm. So at our eyepiece in the instrument, when we see the distance between the top crosshair and the bottom crosshair is 5 mm. So this is our final answer. I is equal to 5 mm. This is the solution of question number 2. I is known as stadia interval. We have to calculate the stadia interval, small I, and we have calculated it as 5 mm. Now we'll see numerical 3 based on this case number 1 of fixed hair method. A staff is held vertically at a distance of 50 meter and 100 meter from the center of the theodolite with a stadia hair. So we have two staff stations, 50 meter and 100 meter distance. The staff intercept with the telescope is 0.500 and 1.000 respectively. The instrument was then set up over a station P of RL 1850.95 meter, and the total height of the instrument was 1.475 meter. The hair reading on a staff held vertically at station Q were 1.050, 1.900 and 2.750 with the line of sight horizontal. So you can see if it is not given whether it is case number 1, 2 or 3, by carefully analyzing the question we can decide whether it is question of case number 1, 2 or 3. Here it is written as the line of sight is horizontal and the staff is held vertical. That means this is case number 1 numerical. So using these values, we have to calculate the horizontal distance between PQ, that is the distance D between station P and Q, and the RL of point Q. So we will use this formula, D is equal to KS plus C, first to calculate the tachyometric constant. Then we will use these values to calculate our capital D. First I will show you the diagram so that you get an idea. So these are our two stations, P and Q. RL of station P is given as 1850.950 meter. The height of instrument is given as 1.475 meter. As the instrument is having horizontal line of sight, theta is equal to 0. If we add this height of instrument in RL of station, we get the RL of height of instrument. It is given as 1852.425 meter, which meets at the middle crosshair reading at the staff intercept. So here top crosshair reading is 2.750, middle crosshair reading is 1.900, and bottom crosshair reading is 1.050. We will use our formula, D is equal to KS plus C. First, station number 1, where the distance was 50 meter. So 50 is equal to K, which is unknown, C is unknown. Staff intercept 1 is given as 0.005. Here you can see in the question, At 50 meter distance, the staff intercept is 0.500. And in D2, when D2 will be 100 meter, the staff intercept S2 will be 1.000. So D1 is 50, S1 is 0.005. This makes our equation number 1. Again, D2 is equal to K S2 plus C, where D2 is 100 and S2 is 1. Both these values are given in our question. As I showed you, this is D2 100 and this is S2 1. So this is our equation number 2. So if we rearrange equation number 1 in terms of C, we get the value of C as 50 minus 0.005 K. Let us give this equation as number 3. So we have the value of C in equation number 3. We will now put the value of C from this equation 3 into our equation number 2. We will put the value of C, that is 50 minus 0.005 K, here. So our new equation will be, this is equation number 2. We have placed the value of C here. So new equation becomes 100 is equal to 1 multiplied by K plus 50 minus 0.005 K. Solving this equation in our calculator, we get the value of K as 100. The multiplying constant is 100. Now we will put this value of K in our equation number 3. So our equation number 3 is C is equal to 50 minus 0.005 K from the previous slide. So we'll put the value of K as 100 here. So C is equal to 50 minus 0.005 multiplied by 100. The value of C is 0. So the value of multiplying constant K is 100 and value of additive constant C is 0. So if the value of K is 100 and C is 0, it means that our instrument is perfectly working and we can move forward with our next calculations. So now we have to calculate the horizontal distance between station P and Q. Having these staff intercepts readings, that is top 2.750, middle 1.900 and bottom 1.050. These other values I have explained earlier. So we'll move forward with the calculation part. Our main formula, D is equal to Ks plus C. So now in this case, staff intercept S is top reading minus bottom reading. So top reading here is 2.750 and bottom reading is 1.050. We have taken these values from here, 2.750 top reading minus 1.050 bottom reading. It gives the value of 1.700. We have the value of S as 1.700. K we have calculated as 100. C we have calculated as 0. So now we'll put all these three values in our equation number 1 and we will find out our distance between station P and Q. So D is equal to Ks plus C. K is equal to 100, S is equal to 1.700 and C is equal to 0. Adding this, we get the value of D as 170 meter. So the distance between station P and Q is 170 meter. We have calculated the first part from the question, that is the horizontal distance between station P and Q. Now we have to calculate the second part of the question, that is calculation of RL of point Q. So what do you mean by RL of point Q? In the diagram, we can see, we know the RL of station P as 1850.950. We have to calculate what is the height of this point Q. So the formula will be RL of station P plus height of instrument, we will get here, minus this middle crosshair reading 1.900. This will give us the RL of station Q. So in the formula we can see RL of station Q is equal to RL of station P, which was 1850.950 plus height of instrument, it was 1.475. Here I will show you, height of instrument is 1.475. Adding both these, we get the value 1852.425, which is written here. This is the addition of both these values, minus 1.900, which is the middle crosshair reading at station Q. Here you can see this is the middle crosshair reading, 1.900. So solving these values, we get the RL of station Q as 1850.525 meter, and this is the final solution of this numerical number 3. We have calculated the RL of point Q as 1850.525 meter, and we have calculated the distance between station P and Q as 170 meter. So that this distance D is calculated and RL of station Q is also calculated. With this, we have finished case number 1. In the next part, we will see the numericals of case number 2. Till then, have a nice time and study well. Thank you very much.